Does your law firm bill your clients for the time of the associate attorneys? Well, then you need to know how to create billable time activities. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. If you bill clients for time that your workers or service vendors work on the job, you will mark the time activity as billable when you record it. You must enter the rate that you are billing the client for each billable hour at the moment you enter the time activity. You will see the billable time on the unbilled time report until it is placed on an invoice and billed to the client. But first, you need to activate billable time in the account and settings window. So, from the top right, we click the cog wheel, we go over to Account and Settings, and the bottom category on the left is Advanced. We click and scroll down to the section of Time Tracking. Now this says Make Single Time Activity Billable to Customer. If we click anywhere in the section, we are able to edit the section, and it's the bottom button that we're focusing on right now. So just click so it moves to the right, acknowledging that we can now bill clients for time. Then we click Save. Then in the bottom right, click Done. How do we know we changed the settings? Well, if we click New and go to Single Time Activity, now you see the billable box is here for you to indicate if you are billing this time activity to a client. For example, let's imagine on June 25th, Lana the lawyer did 12 hours of work that was billable to Alan Arby the client. Lana's hourly rate is $150 per hour. After we record this, we will see the results in the unbilled time report. So, we go to the top left, and we click New, and we go Single Time Activity, and we know it's Lana the lawyer, and the date is June 25th. So we go, I'm using 2021 for our little story, and the client was Alan Arby. Let's double check that, yes. And it was $150 an hour. Notice by default, automatically, the billable box is checked, which is what we want. And we want to put $150 an hour. Now when we click Save and Close, oh, we want to put the number of hours here. So we put 12 hours of work on that one day billed at $150 an hour to the client. And when we click save and close, we can then click reports and go down to unbilled time, double click, and you see the only unbilled time we have was that single time activity that we just made for June 25th for Lana the lawyer. We can double click and go back to the time activity and edit anything you need or read the description more clearly. And now let's bill Alan for the hours that Lana worked. Let's imagine on June 28th, we billed Alan for the 12 hours that Lana worked on June 25th. So we click in the top left, New, Invoice. We advance the date to June of 2021. It's June 28, And as soon as we choose the customer, Alan, you will notice in the right panel the time activity that we just recorded for Lana shows up here in the total amount. And we click Add. The hours, rate, and quantity show up on the invoice, and all we have to do is click Save and Close. And now the unbilled time report has nothing because we have just billed Alan for the time slip that we just created. And if you want to see the result, you can click Reports, Profit and Loss by Client, and you can see in the column of Alan, we now have billable hours in the income section for $1,800, increasing our gross profit and our net income with Alan the client. Now, you probably noticed when we checked the profit and loss that income from billable hours by Lana was recorded into the default income account called billable hours. Hours is an item that QuickBooks Online put on the list of products and services. It is connected to the income account called billable hours. It's the same result as putting the hours item directly on an invoice. Hours is the default item for billable time slips and timesheets, and the following video shows how you can make your own items and use those for billable hours. In the meantime, let's do example two. Let's imagine on June 30th, Andy the attorney worked 8 hours for the client, Betty Boop. We bill him at $135 an hour. So let's go ahead and do that. We click New, Single Time Activity. The date was June 30th. The associate was Andy the attorney. And it's work for Betty Boop. And this time it's billable. So make sure the green check mark is there. Billable at $135 an hour. And we will enter the time directly. And we said it was 8 hours of work. We click Save and Close. And now we can click Reports and go down to unbilled time. That the only unbilled time we have now is the one single time activity from Andy the attorney for the client, Betty Boop. Now, let's see what happens. On July 2nd, we billed Betty for the hours that Andy worked on June 30th. So let's take a look. We click New, Invoice, and this time we're up to July 2nd. And at the moment that we choose Betty Boop, you see on the right the billable time that we can just click Add, and those hours automatically get added to the invoice on July 2nd of 2021. Now, we could add other things the way we learned in prior videos, but at the moment we click Save and Close, you notice it disappears from the unbilled time report, and it is no longer unbilled. Where will the result show? If you click Reports and you click Profit and Loss by Client, you can see that billable hours for Betty Boop in the column of Betty Boop that Andy just did the work for on July 2nd now increases that income to $1,080.